Hello guys, welcome to my channel. This is Uday Pandit and you are watching MEP Technical World. So in this video we'll learn about how to do off delay timer wiring. Okay, so before I start the session, I would like to request you, if you are not yet subscribed my channel, please subscribe my channel and also hit the bell icon so you'll get notification regarding my upcoming videos. So let's get started. So here I have taken off delay timer. So this is the off delay timer which is made by Schneider Electric. Okay, this is the model number and here we have a wiring diagram details or contact details. Okay, contact terminals details. So as per this A1 and A2, so here is A1 and this is A2 terminal of this off delay timer. So these are the coil supply terminal. Okay, timer coil supply terminal. And here we have a like NO contact. Okay, through which we are giving trigger input signal to this terminal. So Y1 terminal is actually trigger input terminal. So this is the trigger input terminal, so Y1. Okay. Now, if we talk about its contact details, so here we have a contact details. So it has a relay, so timer relay, so its contact detail is over here. So 15 number is actually common terminal, okay, common terminal. And 16 number is NC contact. NC means normally closed contact. And 18 number is normally open contact, which is NO contact actually. Okay, so if we look into this timer, so 15 number is here. So this is the actually common terminal. And 16 number is over here. So this is actually NC terminal. And 18 number is here. So this is NO terminals. Okay. So basically these are the contact details. So here we have a supply details. So we can supply 24 volt DC across this terminal. Even we can apply DC AC as well, 240 volt AC across its terminal. Okay, so we can apply both AC as well as DC. Okay, and here we have a contacts. So we can use this contact for AC supply, which current capacity is up to 8 ampere. So we can connect load over here up to 8 ampere. Okay, if we have a load more than 8 ampere, suppose 15 ampere, then we cannot connect this load directly to this contact because it is up to 8 ampere. So first you have to operate any contactor or additional any relays, then you can use the another loads if you have a rating more than this. Okay, so these are the details which we have to know before the wiring. Okay, and here we have a front of this timer, we have a time settings. So with the help of this two knobs we can set the off delay time setting. Okay, so we'll talk it later how to actually set the timer. Okay, now let's move to the wiring. So here I have taken double pole MCB for main supply and this is the one-way switch which we have used for triggering this timer, trigger this timer. Okay, now this is the timer, off delay timer, and these are the loads. Okay, so this load is actually we are going to control through this timer with the help of this switch. Okay, now let's start the wiring. Here we have a 220 volt AC supply source. So from here let's connect neutral to over here at input terminal of this double pole MCB and from L terminal, which is live or we can say phase terminal, it is connected to input terminal of this MCB. Now first let's complete neutral wiring, then we'll come to phase wiring. Okay, so from here let's give the neutral supply to this timer, so connected to A2 terminal. So here at A2 terminal we have connected neutral wire, so this black one is neutral wire. Okay, now let's give the neutral supply to these loads. It also required neutral supply. Okay, so from the output terminal of this MCB, let's take a black wire and connect it to the these two loads. Okay, so these two are AC operated lamp or bulb, you can say LED bulbs. Now let's come to phase wiring. So let's take a red wire from this MCB output terminal and connect it to the A1 terminal. Okay, now this timer got phase and neutral supply, phase at A1 terminal and neutral at A2 terminals. So for trigger input supply, we are going to supply through this switch. Okay, so let's take a wire and connect it to the input terminal of this switch, and from the output terminal of this switch, it is connected to the AY1 terminal, which is trigger input terminal. Now up to here we have connected across this coil terminal and at trigger input terminal through this switch. Now let's use these contacts, 15 number common terminal and 16 number NC and 18 number NO terminals. So here actually what we want, this bulb, we want when we switch on this switch, this bulb should be on at that time, okay, and this bulb should be off, okay, at that time. And when we switch off this switch at that time, what we want, this bulb should be off after some delays, suppose 5 seconds, okay, and this bulb should be on. So after some delay, when we switch off it, up to 5 seconds this bulb should be on, and after 5 seconds this bulb will be off and this bulb will be on. Basically this system actually we want. Okay, so for that, first let's give phase supply to this 15 number terminal. So from here, from A1 terminal, we can loop through a wire. So at 15 number we can connect a wire. So here we have a now phase supply. Now from 18 number, which is NO point, from here let's take a wire and give it to this bulb. Okay, now from 16 number, which is NC contact, let's give it to this bulb. So up to here we have completed wiring of this off delay timer. Okay, so initially at normal condition we have not switched on this MCB, even not this switch. So at normal condition this bulb is at off and this bulb is at on, because 16 number is NC contact, that's why it is already on. Okay, now let's set the time delay. Okay, off delay time setting. Suppose we want the bulb will be off after 5 seconds when we switch off this power supply. Okay, so here is the knob for time setting. Okay, so these are the two time setting knobs. So actually this is for time range and this is for multiplying factor. Okay, so this is the range of from 1 second to 100 hours. So this is the range of this timer setting, of delay timer setting. Okay, suppose we want to set 5 seconds. Okay, so we can set it to this 1 to 10 seconds. So we have to set this knob at this 1 to 10 seconds. So actually what we want, 5 seconds. So let's rotate it to over here and at 5 seconds. Now multiply 1 with this multiplying factor 5, so it become 5 seconds. So in this way we can set timer. If you want to 7 seconds, then set it to 7. If you want to 10 seconds, then set it to 10. So 1 multiply with 10 means 10 seconds. Okay, so in this way we can set the timer. If you want to 12 seconds, then we can set up to 6 and set it to 2. So 6 into 2 means 12 seconds. Okay, if you want to set in minute, then we can rotate it to minute section. So in this way we can set the time of this timer. Okay, so now let's move basically how this timer works of delay timers. So here we have set 5 seconds. Okay, so first let's switch on this MCB. So here we have switch on this MCB. Still this bulb is off and this bulb is on because it is NC. Okay. Now when we switch on this switch, actually what happened? Let's see. So let's switch on this switch. So here we have switch on this switch. Okay. So actually now when we switch on this switch, its contact get changed like this here, NO to NC. So NO NC become NO and NO become NC. That's why now this bulb is off and this bulb is on. Okay. So at a time when we switch on this switch, at a time its contact get changed, NO from NC and NC from NO. That's why this bulb is now off and this bulb is on, because now 18 number become NC, as you can see over here. Okay. So in this way this timer works when we switch on this switch. So at this time this timer doesn't start the time counting, because here we use off delay timer, that's why it doesn't start the time counting. So when it start the time counting, so let's see it. So this bulb is still on and this bulb is still off. So when again we switch off it, actually what happened? Now it starts the time counting. So when we switch off it, this bulb will not get turned off and this bulb will not even get turned on, because here we have set off delay time setting 5 seconds. So up to 5 seconds this bulb will be on. Okay. After 5 seconds only this bulb will be off. Okay. So when we switch off this, it starts the time counting like 1. So up to 1 this bulb is also on and this bulb is also off. So it starts like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So up to 5 seconds this bulb is still on and this bulb is still off. And after 5 seconds what happened? Its contact get again changed, so it become to normal like this. Okay. Now finally this bulb get off and this bulb get on after 5 seconds when we switch off this switch. Okay. So now as you can see over here, this 18 number terminal become NO and this 16 number is become NC. That's why this bulb is on and this bulb is off. So actually what happened? When we switch off this, it means it starts the time counting. Up to this time setting this bulb will be on and this bulb is off. So when we switch off it, it starts the time counting 1, 2, 3, 4, and after 5 seconds its contact get changed and this bulb will be off. So after delay when we switch off it, so after some second, suppose here we have set 5 seconds, means after 5 seconds only this bulb will be off. Okay. So in this way this off delay timer works. Okay. So in this way we can do the wiring of this off delay timer wherever you required this type of application. Okay. So let's talk about its application. In projector we have a cooling fan. So here we have used off delay timer actually. So when we switch off this projector, after few seconds only this cooling fan will be off. Okay. And another application is in chiller plant, in condenser pump. Okay. So when we switch off the water cooled chiller plant, so after some times this condenser pump will be off. So here we have also used off delay timer. Okay. Another one is interior lights, car interior lights. So when we close the door, so after closing the door these bulbs are still on for some seconds. So because here we use off delay timer, that's why when we close the door it is still on for some seconds. Okay. And another one is exhaust or fresh air units fans. So here we have also used off delay timer. Okay. So after some second only when we switch off this fan, after some delay only this ventilation fans or exhaust or fresh air fans will be turned off. Okay, so these are the applications of off delay timers. So up to you, wherever you required off delay operations, where you can use off delay timer. Okay, so in this video we have learned about off delay timer wiring and its application. So hope you guys understand about off delay timer wiring. So thank you for watching this video. Please like, share, comment and subscribe, and also hit the bell icon so you'll get notification regarding my upcoming videos. So thank you very much. See you again in next video.